Hello YouTube, I'm back with another in-depth review. This time I'm playing Nidalee in the jungle and I'm against the Diana. The runes and masteries are in the description of the video, as well as the timestamps of the plays and mistakes for those of you who don't like to raid around too much. Now, I don't really play Nidalee. She was pretty bad in the recent past, but now she's pretty decent again, so I decided to pick her up once more. But yeah, the early clear on Nidalee is pretty hard to do, and you will see me make a lot of small mechanical mistakes. I will point them out for you so you don't make them. I'm starting my blue because Nidalee really needs her blue buff. And I can clear this side of the jungle faster in the early levels. So Nidalee's almost always start blue. So this is my first mistake. I don't proc the first hunt. It gives bonus damage on your Q, so you should really proc it. Also not the best leash from my top laner, but it will be okay. Nidalee has a lot of regeneration, especially when you're low. So it will be fine. Just clearing out this side of the jungle. Don't really have a plan in the early game because all the lanes are pretty hard to gank. I thought Garen would be top side. I would have ganked Garen then, but Garen is mid. So that's not gonna happen. The lane is too short for me to gank Garen. You can just run away. When I have some more damage, I can go for it if I hit a Q. So I'm becoming pretty low in the jungle. And I'm gonna decide to do the river grab to heal up some. Yeah, Diana is also on this side of the map. Didn't know that, of course. I'm just gonna do this. But yeah, she sees me, and she's higher health than I am. She is level 2 though, so if I hit a spear, I could have went in, but I didn't, so I'm just gonna clear. Echo just killed the mid laner, and Diana is after him, so I'm gonna help him. And I hit my spear. She flashes away, I flash after her, I proc the hunt, and then kill her with an auto attack. Early kill, that's very nice. It's not first blood though. I don't know who got first blood. I believe the Zed did. I'm just gonna clear the rest of it. After a few levels with Nidalee, it's so easy to clear. You clear so fast. The main reason you want to pick Nidalee is because of your farming. You can snowball through farm and annoy the enemy jungler in his jungle. I'm not really doing that in this game, but I should have, because this Diana is very bad. She's building the wrong way, even now. And yeah, when you see that, you want to abuse that. So I'm gonna go back here because I'm a bit too low. Then go for the raptors. It's gonna be a very long game and a very exciting one. Especially the team fights in the mid to late game are pretty intense. Nidalee is not too great at team fighting, to be honest. We really want to make picks and want to make, yeah, want to snowball and to control the map because you are stronger than most junglers. I wanted to see if I could find this Diana, but I just miss her. And nothing is up for me to steal, so just gonna go for a bot gank. I didn't mean to hit that plant, because now they could have known where I was. So I hit my spear on Nidalee, but I should have waited until the flash came out. I wouldn't have gotten her anyway, because I was exhausted, but yeah, if I waited out the exhaust and then W onto Nami, excuse me, and I would have gotten her. I wanted to do a lane gank, but the Leona said it was warded, and we can see it here in the corner. So I'm just gonna go back to farming. So yeah, Nidalee's strengths are her jungle clear, her counter jungling ability, because you have a jump every few seconds, so you can easily get out over walls and such. So nothing to do with my bot side. I'm not really walking efficiently here. And I just missed this spear. It's just at the end of the range. Or I could have flashed on him and killed him. Sorry, I don't have flash. We might have been able to kill him there, but I don't know for sure. Finally clearing this side. I wasted a lot of time with that early invade. And I didn't get anything off of it, so that put me behind a little bit. I'm still even with the Diana. But like I said, that's not really a compliment. She's very bad, so... Now my clear has sped up quite a bit. When you become level 6, your clear is insanely good. I don't think anyone can clear faster than you can. Maybe an AP Zac or something, but you don't really see that a lot. Missed my trap here, gonna pull it in so I get an extra reset on my W. Don't have any mana anymore. But yeah, your abilities in Cougar form don't cast mana. Just gonna camp, kite the camp around a little bit. Yeah, Nidalee doesn't really have to back if she has blue. She can just heal herself. And we have plants nowadays. And I can also heal up from the river crab, so... Yeah, don't back too quickly with Nidalee. Just heal up. See if you can maybe steal some camps. So I'm not really interested in the first Drake. It's only a Cloud Drake. I don't care. Wanted to maybe go for Garen here. He's backing off. Just gonna get this CS. Yeah, not getting those. So I revealed myself where I was. For those two CS, it wasn't really worth, but if I got all of them, it was worth for sure. Always make... make that determination. Is it worth to let them know where you are? With things like Shaco or Evelynn, you don't want to do that a lot, because most of your power lies in that they don't know where you are. But the same goes for Nidalee, to be honest, because you can... You usually want to use your spear when you are in the fog of war. It's very hard to dodge if they can't see it coming, but if they see you and they see you throw a spear, it's just too easy to dodge. It's a very slim skill shot. It's very long, but very easy to dodge if you sidestep. Missing a lot of abilities here, misclicking. Like I said, I'm not really used to Nidalee. You really have to play her a lot to become fluent in her abilities. So, but about the status of the game. My Echo is doing pretty well. He died once, but he also got 3 kills. I also got a kill there. But my Teemo is losing from the Zed. That shouldn't be really be possible. This Zed is probably just a lot better than this Teemo. And yeah, that's a lane that I usually... don't want to gank, because Teemo has insanely high lane pressure. And he should be able to lane on its own, but this one can't. And yeah, I don't want to gank a Zed that is probably one level ahead of me and an item. He just one-shots me. I'm also going for Zhonya's first. Yeah, the jungle AP jungle item first and then Zhonya's, just because of the Zed. And they, of course, have a lot of AD. I'm gonna see if I can get some camps here. This one is up, and that's nice. I didn't know they were doing dragon, but I will hear that soon. And then I can easily take the Krugs as well. Because I know Diana is near the dragon. Or, well, I don't know for sure, but I expect that. And trading a Cloud Drake for these two camps, I will make that trade every time. These two camps give so much experience and gold. I will put Diana very far behind now, because I took those camps. Yeah, Zed killed Teemo again. I'm not gonna go there. If I miss my spear, he will just kill me, so... And he will probably kill me even if I hit my spear. I really want some armor first. I got some now. It makes me a little bit more durable. But I really need that Zonias as soon as possible. It's good against their entire team. It's good against Garen. It's good against Diana. It's good against Sivir. And of course it's good against Zed. Blue team's turret has been destroyed. If he dares to ult me, I just... yeah, Zonias and his ult is wasted. He also has an Edge of Night though, so I should be careful because he also has a lot of magic resist now. And that spell shield of his. We see Diana in my jungle, so I'm gonna check her jungle. Teemo stopped Diana from taking my blue, so that's pretty nice. Yeah, nothing is up here. Unstoppable. But the wolves are. So this is what you wanna be doing as Nidalee. Especially if you are against lanes that are very hard to gank. And yeah, my lanes are hard to gank this game. Zed is not gankable for me, not really. And the bot lane has a spell shield and the Nami disengage. Don't really want to come there either. I'm just gonna wait until the laning phase is over. And then try to poke down the enemy. Because that's where you're really good at poking and counter jungling. Controlling the map. That's the thing you want to do as Nidalee. Just gonna clear this so Garen can take the turret. Try and get him off of it. But yeah, I can't really kill him. Not gonna try because he will turn around, silence me, E me, and then ult me and I'm dead. But yeah, if I can get a spear on Garen, and then just get my combo off before he can silence me. That's the only way I can kill him. It is an AD Garen though. Until now at least. He will be a bit more tanky later on. But I can still one-shot him with my combo. But I'm afraid for that silence. It really screws you over. To mid. I'm just gonna see if I can get some poke off. And I hit Zed. And Echo gets the kill. That's very good that we shot down that guy. Gives our team extra gold. And it gives Teemo time to catch up. Because Teemo will be useful later on. His shrooms alone are useful, but his blind will be useful as well. Especially against their team. If he can just blind Sivir or Zed, then a lot less damage will come out in the team fight. But yeah, I'm not gonna help him with my ganks because we will probably both die. Don't gank the losing lanes. Echo gets a kill on Diana as well. I could have invaded her there. I should have. Because I knew she was dead. Trying to poke them off the turret, but it's too late. Turret is gone. And yeah, they know I'm here now. So they're gonna annoy me. And I'm not gonna risk it. Just gonna wait until my Leona gets here. And then go for Zed. So I jump in without hitting my spear. I get exhausted, so I need to wait that out. Flash the Zed ult, because if he hit those shurikens, I would have been dead. Jump away from his shadow, and then when he is CC'd and walking away, you throw a spear in the back of his head. I get the kill, I love those. Missed the spear on Garen. He's too fast. But yeah, we got Zed and we got the Nami, only for our Echo, so it was worth. We can go for the Drake now. My team is already starting it. I'm just walking over now. It's a Earth Drake, so a lot more important than the Cloud Drake. I really love those Drakes, because it will make it so much easier to get Baron and turrets. Bad smite by me. and just gonna continue farming. I have more than double the CS of the Diana. I don't know what she's doing. Berserker Greaves, it doesn't make any sense what she's building. She's actually wood. Because if you don't understand why this doesn't work on Diana, then you can't be good. People are trying all kinds of stupid things in normals. But yeah, some things just don't work. You can try it, but yeah, you will lose, or you will... It will become a 4v5. You didn't see that, by the way. Me missing that spear. But yeah, you're only gonna annoy your allies. And you're gonna help your enemy. So if that's your goal, then build Berserker Greaves on Diana. But if you want to get better, really get better, think about why that doesn't work. Think about what works on Diana. And then go try that out. So yeah, there are two people here in the top lane. I can keep them busy for a little while. And it gives room to my team to get some kills in the bot side. I already am building towards Zonia's. Almost got it. Probably have the gold for it now, but... Need to go back to base soon. Just to buy that. Then I can bait the Z ulti. It's still hard for me to kill him. If I hit a spear, it will be better, but... Yeah, he will just ult me when I jump in. And then I just Zonia's, and yeah, we both get out. So I rather just go for the Diana, or go for the Sivir when she used her spell shield. Those are better targets for me. Red team's turret has been destroyed. Finally got the bot tower, that's good. We need some towers. We can finally clear this camp without being interrupted by Zed and Nami. Yeah, we see them at our blue buff. We are walking over. They didn't get it. It's walking back now. My Echo is going in. So we need to help him. This Garen is split up from his team, so we can just focus him. There are two assassins here that need to go in. So if they don't, we can just kill Garen easily. Nothing much else happens in this team fight, I believe. Just clear out the vision, poke a little bit. I still haven't gotten my Zonia's, I believe. Not really sure though. Just gonna see if I can hold the bot side. Because we don't want Sivir to get that turret. Here I'm looking for the good angle to hit my Q. And I hit my Q. But yeah, she has ult. And her spell shield. But that's not gonna happen. And I miss all the CS here as well. So that put me behind a little bit, but I saved the tower. So that's pretty worth. Finally got a Zonia's. So all the AD damage will be reduced. And I have a countermeasure against the Zed ult. So clearing my jungle from bot to top, because we know there's a lot of pressure top now with the Zed there. Yeah, I don't know if we saw Garen. Somewhere on the ward. Yeah, we know where Sivir just went back in the bot lane. It's not gonna be any pressure there at the moment. Giving this blue to Echo. The first one I gave. Yeah, he deserves it. He's going pretty ham, but he's getting the job done. Seeing if I can get some poke. Yeah, my poke on Garen is not really effective. Already has two magic resist items. But yeah, at least I keep his passive from going up. So we see Diana in the bot lane on her own. And that's just a perfect target for me. Always go for the weak ones and always go for the stupid ones. because they are predictable and bad, and it's easy to get fed on. And it's not sad for that one, it's just... yeah, smart for you to do that. But wait until her shield goes down. Or almost goes down. She interrupts my W, but it doesn't matter. She's so far behind. I can easily jump into her. Normally a Diana is way more powerful than a Nidalee, and I wouldn't be able to jump in like that. But yeah, she's probably 3 levels behind and a whole item. Now I can just split push this lane. I'm pretty good at split pushing, because you have attack speed burst and you have a lot of AoE. And that gave us a lot of map pressure, those few kills. Warding up this side of the jungle, if you want to fight here now, it's pretty good for us. And I'm just gonna go for dragon. It's only a cloud drake though. But yeah, let's just get it off the map. They are chasing our team, so at least we can trade a dragon for it. I can just leave through the back. Garen was waiting there in the bush, hoping someone would face check, but nope. Not gonna happen. Not yet, at least. I missed that spear, or it would have been a kill. And I didn't expect the Garen here, so here it happens. Yeah, Izonia has the combo from Diana, but I will just die to Garen. It's AD Garen, so one rotation of his spells will kill me. And yeah, I hoped I would Sonya's the Garen ult, but I was too fast. But I would have died to the Diana combo, so it doesn't really matter. I was dead anyways. But still, 70 CS, 80 CS ahead of Diana, so I'm not complaining. Oh, and here's the part with the Clown Fiesta teamfight. Yeah, this is a bad part by me. So the Zed is going for the Echo, and I wanted to heal the Echo. Yeah, he's ulting out. I can't reach him. But yeah, he still dies. And here I make a mistake with pathing. I wanted to jump over immediately, and I could have flash Q'd the Garen, and he would have died. But yeah, I mess up. And here I do something even more stupid. I'm gonna go for the flash Q. But yeah, Nami is still there, she exhausts me, and Garen was too tanky anyway, so this was just so stupid. And this team fight really fucks us over, because a lot of us died. Luckily there Diana died as well. The team is fighting in a pretty dangerous spot, and it's 4v4. Well, Diana is already there, it's a 4v5 without me. And the Echo, our strongest one, dies. So yeah, I should have been there. It was also my bad. I could have healed Caitlyn here. I forgot that. Luckily she survives anyways. And yeah, here we just want a wave clear, so they can't get too many towers. My Caitlyn backs, that's pretty good. Because else she would get one shot by the Zen. Or Garen. Just gonna try, but it's a 5v2. So we can't stop this. And I need to stay away from Garen. Dodging everything, but the tower still goes down. Going for my red and seeing if I can get a flank off after. Should have gifted it to Caitlyn, to be honest. Way better on her. And yeah, now we saw them retreating through the bot side, so I'm pinging Baron now. because we are pretty grouped. And this is just a very good call. I love when my team responds like this. That just doesn't happen often, especially in normals. Okay, I've got the execute on my Q. So I'm not really worried it's gonna be stolen. Yeah, their team is a bit split up. The Garen is on the other side. Yeah, now they are gonna surround us. But we just need to pick a side and go there with all of us. And we do. But it was pretty nicely played. The Diana gets CC'd and gets a spear into her face. Caitlyn gets all the kills, so that's pretty nice. And yeah, here I go a bit ham, but you can always try. Spell shield is down. I got the ult, so I'm not dissatisfied. And we can just go for a mid push. If they stay, we can try and dive them, because we know where Garen is dead. And that's the one with the most disruption. Nami can try and slow us down, but yeah, her abilities won't, unless she hits her bubble. And now we rotate to the bot side, there's a minion wave is there. And we can easily push down this turret as well, and maybe go for the Drake after. But yeah, that's a bit too much, to be honest. Everyone is walking down, and they know we are gonna go for Dragon. It's the only logical choice. Yeah, maybe we could have done it. But yeah, I ping them back. Because I don't want to give up our Baron buff. It's not worth it for this Drake. And yeah, we can just get a pick on mid lane. I flash Q the Zed, but he flashes that. But Teemo gets him, so it's pretty worth. I'd rather have Zed dead than a Mountain Drake at this moment. Because we already took the Baron. It's not gonna help for that. And yeah, now I can take the blue buff. Because our Echo died. Mwahaha! He doesn't deserve it when he's dead. Still some ADCS above the Diana. Still not worried about her. Wanted to go and kill her again, but the rest of my team walks that way as well. Get scared. Diana shouldn't split push because she's the weakest in the entire game. And the weakest shouldn't split push, they should farm under their turret. So we still have Baron buff. Gonna do a push in the bot side. And the rest of my team is going mid. Actually, we should have went top, but it's okay. I thought Sivir would be in this tri-bush because we saw her come over, but we lost sight of her. Too bad. She walked the other way. Do we see Nami here? I tried to spear her, but I hit the Diana. I tried to kill her. But yeah, we can just get wrecked by the Garen, who was standing on the other side. Luckily, my team is doing good in this team fight. But yeah, Zed is just now entering it. And he's the strongest one. They can kill him as well, it would be worth, but he is gonna kill everyone. The Shroom isn't enough. And yeah, Leona just gets closed in. So this was a very bad fight for us. We were too split up, and the Garen just dunked me. It was bad by me. The Diana is not worth it. Trying to get this Garen off the turret. But yeah, he's too fast. He even outruns my spear. Not really sure where their team is, so I'm warding my own jungle. Got that monster. Yeah, the rest of my camps are gone. This red I'm gonna give to Kate, I believe. Yes. It's so much better on her. With all her range. They are chasing the Zed, I believe. He's gonna go for Caitlyn. But we get him as well. Oh, he went for the Teemo. Yeah. Well, Teemo for Zed is very worth it, in my opinion. But the Garen is pushing the bot side. I'm gonna help Leona. And yeah, she's a CC bot. And if I have CC, this Garen is no problem. I can just hit all my spears without him running away. But yeah, he overstayed. He should have backed off when he saw no one on the map. I'm not pushing out top lane anymore, because I still don't know where half that team is. Just gonna get some vision around the Baron, because it will be soon be up. If he can get another Baron, we can get a lot of their base turrets. So that's our win condition at the moment. Getting another blue buff. The Echo is not around, so I can take it. Nyeh, nyeh. So we see EZ in the top lane now. I was seeing if I can get some poke on him. If I hit the spear now, it's like 50% of his HP, so... That should make him go back if I hit one. So I flash Q the Diana to execute her. And the Teemo poison gets it. So this is a bit messy team fight because everyone gets panicked by the Zed. And here's something funny. I tried to go for the Garen and I accidentally hit the Nami. That's very good for us because now they don't have healing anymore. Every bit of poke I hit now, it will stick. A lot of... Look at those Edge of Knights. Yeah, I can't really hit poke with all those spell shields. Everyone there had a spell shield. Sivir, Garen. And Zed. So just gonna wait until they expire. But yeah, our jungle is warded pretty well. So they know where I am. Wanted to go for some poke. But it's not gonna happen. Push out this wave. Break is up now and the Baron is up. Yeah, we are almost inside our base and our mid lane. This is a bit of a screw up by Zed. And that Edge of Night. Oh my god, he walked over that shroom, but the Edge of Night disabled it. If it was one patch in the future, he would have died there. I'm pinging the Baron. Because I suspect they are doing Elder Drake and I really want to trade it. I'm waiting for my tank to get here. Now we just need to rush it. Not really worried that anyone will steal it again. But yeah, the Garen can one-shot me. We get it again. And the Garen comes over it as well. I am running away because I don't want to die to the Zed and my team can just finish it, so no need to be greedy. I walk towards the Diana, she's doing the stupid thing again. I hit my spear, so she's dead. No way she can survive that. I'm still 2 levels higher than her, I think. Maybe more. Ah, 1 level only. It's already level 18, so... Now she's gonna be stronger than me if she had the right item, but she doesn't. But yeah, she will kill me 1v1 if I don't hit the spear. when she's level 18 at least. Not yet. Yeah, that build just doesn't make sense. Why would you go health? Why would you go AD? Attack speed, okay, Triforce. Yeah, there's maybe something good about that, but the rest just doesn't make sense. Anyways, we are ruining our Baron a little bit. I should have kept pushing in the bot lane. Would have been a bit dangerous though. If Gavin comes from behind, his combo will one-shot me and I can't jump away or flash away, for that matter. Yeah, not much is really happening. Our Echo is going back now, so... we lose a lot of damage then. I fuck up my W. Making sure no one's coming here. And yeah, here we flank the team. Yeah, I missed my spear. Very bad spear to miss, to be honest. Yeah, we get nothing from it. I should have hit that spear and waited for her to flash. And then get her. But I messed that up. Trying to get some poke in. Go for the bot side. You know, just leaving top side for what it is. And yeah, here I mess up. I get poked by a Diana, that shouldn't be possible. And here I go in. But yeah, I get a lot of damage, I don't know where it's from. I believe it's the Z combo and the ricochets from Sivir. But yeah, this was just too greedy from us. We shouldn't have engaged there. Yeah, at least the Echo gets the Nami. Yeah, because the Sivir is focusing the Leona, he can also get the Sivir. Yeah, there's my dead body. Yeah, the Garen gets the Echo. Because Echo was the villain. Garen did a lot of damage to him. And yeah, with Echo dead, I can just take the blue buff. It's better on me now, because this Echo is just dying too much. So I see Zed here. I thought he would go for me, but he's gonna go for the Caitlyn. But yeah, that's a better target indeed, because I have Sonya. And yeah, he kills her. Now we need to wait until the Caitlyn is back up, because yeah, she's now her top damage dealer. At 6 items, the ADCs are almost always the top damage dealer. Zed does a lot of damage, of course, in the late game. And Teemo does a lot of damage. But yeah, I think Caitlyn can get it off safer and from a bigger range. And yeah, she's just total AD. So here's another team fight coming, but this time the enemy fucks up. The Diana, of course, fucks up first. I hit the spear on her, kill her. And the Echo gets a nice flank off. And I can just jump in and kill Nami. After that, yeah, it's go for Zed. But he gets away, just barely. And we can kill Garen. Nice play by the Echo. Very well done. I'm just gonna chase the Zed so he can't back yet. Don't really care if he hits me with some abilities. I have my heal. There it goes. And yeah, we can hopefully get an inhibitor here. Maybe two. But yeah, Echo is not with us. To be honest, I didn't really notice it. I was too tunnel visioned on the inhibitors. And yeah, this second inhibitor is just too greedy. I get some poke on Zed. Yeah, we shouldn't have went in there. The Zed W's out. I still get him with my burn. So it's not a total loss. But yeah, I lose my GA. And my Leilonia dies as well, and I do after. So probably not worth. We got only one inhibitor. We should have went for the second one. It would have been more worth with two inhibitors down than all of us dead than, that engage. But the Baron is up again. I'm running towards it. If he can just get it very quickly. My team is already going for it. I can just smite it. Teemo gets it with poison. Yeah, we shouldn't team fight here because the Echo went back. I'm just trying to peel... Trying to scare the enemy off of Leona. But yeah, don't come too close yourself because Leona's tanky and you are not. I thought Zed would come around that corner, but not yet. I was too early. Yeah, they have vision of all of us. But we have great vision in this area. And yeah, here the Diana fucks up again. She's too late. She gets CC'd. I get Sonya's here. And I flash away. But Garen flashes after me. And I decide to just go in. I could have backed off even more. And then I would have survived. But this way the Garen died sooner. And now Caitlyn gets a quadra kill. And with the dead timers being 50 seconds, she can just end on her own. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this game. It was not one of my best games, but I did my part. And yeah, I'll speak to you next time. Have a nice day.